Hello, learners. Welcome to the D.El.Ed program in the subject Environmental Studies. I am Manju Jain, former head Department of Elementary Education, NCERT. Today, I am going to take a topic, Determining Assessment Indicators in Environmental Studies. The focus of the present session would be why Environmental Studies learning, that is need of the objectives of the EVS learning, learning outcomes and learning indicators, what are the significance of the learning indicator in the process of learning, need for learning indicators, characteristics of learning indicators, what are the learning indicators, examples in environmental studies, level wise some of the examples we will discuss here. Reporting process. What is the reporting process and what should be the reporting process? How to map the child's progress? And last, role of the teachers and other stakeholders in implementation of learning indicators. Some tips we'll share here. Why EVS learning? We should understand that what are the major expectations of EVS learning. So one of the expectations of EVS learning is learn about the environment. We know the EVS learning is around the environment. It is maybe the immediate surrounding, maybe the distant environment and the wider environment. So its ability to develop an awareness of natural, social and cultural environment deals issues, concepts in an integrated manner rather than in a disciplinary manner by using variety of activities. The second important objective of EVS learning is learning through the environment. Here we are propagating and we are believe that the EVS learning should be through the environment. So the learning resource and learning material should be from the environment. They should be used as a learning material. So, lays emphasis on using various environmental objects from the environment, places we can use as a learning material and learning resource like various monuments, various type of buildings in the vicinity, plants, animals in the immediate surrounding as a learning resource for the children rather than using from the textbooks or the pictures in a concrete manner. Learn for the environment. This is one of the important consideration, one of the important expectations of EVS learning is developing sensitivity for the protection of the environment and emphasizes inculcation of values, attitude and skills related to the protection of the environment. It also includes protection not only in terms of hazardous effects, but also keeping environment clean and healthy. Enhance, promote curiosity and curiosity in relation to the surroundings. Develop an appreciation for diversity, that is various languages used by the community, by the children, family, habits, variation in plants, animal, etc. in the surrounding. And develop sensitivity towards the senior citizens and differently challenged children in the community, focusing on their strength as well as areas of concern. So these are some of the broad expectations. So keeping these objectives and expectation in view, practitioner needs to think about it. What are the challenges of classroom? How she should address these issues in the teaching learning process? So, in order to understand the learning indicators, let us first know what we mean by the indicators and what we mean by the learning outcomes. Because learning outcomes are generally treated as the assessment standards and they are equated with the expected levels of learning, which are generally the outcome and the product based. in the learning outcome, we are just believe in the what the child has done, what is the end product, what is the result, what is the result of the activity the child has done. Learning indicators are expected to provide the evidence of learning and other changes taking place in child's behavior. That is, it provides the checkpoints of the learning outcome. And it is a process based. I am giving you one example that, say for example, a child has done a survey activity in the school. Maybe the survey of different classrooms and the survey of the building of the school premises. If we believe that the what is the outcome, our focus will be on what is the end result, how he or she has prepared the report. While if we will analyze the survey report in terms of the learning indicator, we will focus on process also, along with maybe the end product. So what is the process? The process may include the how a child has designed, what is the planning, what are the preparation he or she has done, how he or she organized the activities, whether the activities they have conducted in a more cordial manner, or what are the problem he or she is facing. We will take into account of such aspects of that activity. So the broad difference in the learning outcome is that these are the process based, where we are focusing on the process which used by the learner, as well as what is the end product. While in the outcome, we are generally focusing on the what is the end result. So the significance for the primary stage, the learning indicator has the great value, because the EVS learning is around the processes. It's a process-based learning. So the significance of learning indicator, it helps the learner to understand learning. It is a learning as a process. It helps the teachers, not only the children, but help the teacher to understand that learning as a process. To understand learning as a process in a continuum. It is not in a planning, is not linked with the implementation part, and implementation part is not linked with the assessment, and assessment part is not linked with the recording and reporting. All are in a continuum. This is one continuum, and as well as the another continuum is the class 3 learning is linked with the class 4th, and class 4 learning is linked with the class 5. So learning is going on in a continuum, in a continuous manner. It providing reference point for the parents, teachers to understand how children learn. The learning indicator also provide a framework for feedback process and reporting process, and also take into cognizance the way children learn. Like we know, children are learning through various kind of processes. Observation, through expression, through writing work, through experimentation. So the learning indicator takes into account of various processes which children follow in a learning. Progress on learning outcome can be assessed through the learning indicator when a child is in the seat of learning. The learning indicator is giving evidence to the learning, and that is beneficial for reporting purpose of the progress of the child in terms of the learning outcome. Learning indicators are providing evidence for learning, and it is a checkpoint to assess child learning at different point of time. It's not the learning at a specific period of time, but learning may be going on at a different point of time. Say for example, the classification ability. Classification ability among the children cannot be achieved, cannot be developed at one point of time. It takes lot of time, and it needs lot of variety of activities to fulfill, to achieve this objective, to achieve this process. So that is also providing scope for developing various processes by using the different kind of learning activities based on that very process in the classroom. The need of the learning indicators. Why we need the learning indicators? Do really teacher know about the learning indicator? What is the significance of learning indicator for a practitioner? So the learning indicator view different aspects of child behavior holistically. So one of the important strength of a teacher, if she knows how to assess the child behavior in terms of holistic development, it means it facilitating a monitoring child progress over a period of time, supporting evidence-based learning rather than the subjective nature of learning, objectivity in learning and assessment process, and providing criteria of assessment. If teacher is assessing child's progress, it provides evidence on what basis she or he should assess or give the grade or give the marks to the children. Now, what are the characteristics? If teacher uses indicator, she must be, being a teacher, you must know what are the features of the learning indicators. So, learning indicators should reflect broad conceptual knowledge and adaptive, vocational and generic skills. It also reflects essential knowledge, skills and attitude. It focuses more on the process of learning. It reflects the desired learning experience during the process of learning. It represents the minimum performances that must be achieved to successfully complete a course or a program. Learning indicator statement may be considered to be the exit behavior. It means exit behavior is the terminal behavior. When we are initiating any plan, we are initiating any teaching learning process, the initial level we are saying it's entry level behavior. But when the teacher is making lot of efforts, she is giving more and more opportunity to the children to learn, it means she is giving lot of intervention, maybe by using some material, she is maybe by using their children's experiences as a learning resource, maybe she is using various strategies to transact the textual material. By this process, children will learn, and that after this whole cycle of learning, the whatever the children have experienced, and if she would like to know what they have learned, that behavior we can say it's a terminal behavior. And with this, by the learning indicators and learning outcome, teacher can easily be distinguish what they know earlier and what they have learned after this process. Now, what are the learning indicators in EVS? All the EVS learning is around the learning indicators. From class 3 to class 5, we are propagating by developing the EVS material, and we are through and through suggesting from our textual material that the text is just an exemplar. The text which is given in the textbook is exemplar or suggestive. But the processes which we have given in the textbook are essential. A teacher must follow these indicators as a process, as a prerequisite, as a non-negotiable component of the teaching. Whenever EVS learning is going on, maybe in the rural area or maybe the urban area or any area, these processes are the generic. But how you use these processes, the content may be different. So the example could be vary, but the processes and their steps will remain the same. So this is the important understanding EVS practitioner or the teachers you must know. Now, the first and foremost important EVS indicator is observation, recording and reporting. And one of the very, very important process of EVS learning is observation. 50% observation is mainly used by the children, and they learn through observation many things. So observation is foremost important process. That is, they are doing an observation by exploring the environment. They are sharing, that is also the observation, narrating and drawing, picture reading, making pictures, collecting and recording information. All these sub activities are using, if the children are using observation as a process of learning. Now, the second important process of learning is learning indicator is the discussion. And discussion is again a very important learning tool and process in environmental studies classroom. Discussion may be in a small group, discussion may be in a large group, discussion may be one-to-one, discussion with parents. So discussion involves listening, discussion involves talking, expressing their own ideas, their opinion. They are discovering, if they are discovering something and sharing with the parents and the peer group or the teacher, that discussion creates the new knowledge. That discussion gives opportunity to the children to construct knowledge. So this is the second important learning indicator. The third important learning indicator is expression. And expression is always a very, very essential feature of EVS classroom, because the EVS learning is not always based on the cognitive activities. It's a much more related to the activities which are psychomotor in nature. So the other personal social qualities or the linkages with other curricular areas, say for example, EVS is interdisciplinary. Interdisciplinary means the linkages with other curricular area. The environmental studies very much related with the art education. The art education activities like drawing, artwork, craft work, these subjects are very close to the learning point of view. And similarly, the health education, physical education, these subjects are very much related with the learning of environmental studies. So the strength of the EVS is how to take into the account of these subject area in the teaching learning process. So expression may involve the expression through gesture, their body movement, body language, children like role play if they are doing it, it's a part of the expression. Expression through drawing, children many a time teacher is giving opportunity, whatever they are thinking, they let them draw. Rather than they are doing this is stereotyping, just draw the house. So it's a kind of shift in the EVS. Whatever they are thinking, they give them opportunity to draw. They can write, expressing through the creative writing. Creative writing they can also do. So many more type of activities if children will do, the expression ability will be much, much better. Now, the fourth important indicator of EVS learning is the explanation. Why this thing? If they would like to describe in their own language, we can say it's an explanation given by the children. So, explanation indicator can be judged by giving some reasoning kind of activity in the classroom. Making simple logical connections between cause and effect. What is the cause and what is the effect? If the summer is there, the fruit and vegetable will spoil much, much in a shorter span rather than in a winter. They can give the explanation of that. What is the cause of spoiling the fruit and vegetable in summer rather than in a winter? Describing events situation, formulating one own's reasoning, their own point of view they will give. This will help a lot to the learner to reflect their own ideas, and that will ultimately develop the among the children the critical thinking. Another important part is the classification ability. Classification is which help learner to identify objects based on the observable features of the objects, observable features found in the surrounding, and also help identifying the similarities. What are the similarities in plants and animal? What are the differences in the plants and animals? So the comparing ability, the grouping ability, the classifying ability, they will develop by this indicator. It's sorting and grouping objects based on the maybe two attribute at a time. Two attribute at a time means the child are classifying plants or the flower, you can say, based on the color of petal and based on the shape of the leaves. Likewise, if they use the three attribute at a time, they may say the size, shape, and the shape of the leaves. Likewise, the complexity will keep on increasing the grades. Maybe in the early grades, children may do the activity by using two attribute at a time, while in a class 4 and 5, the complexity may can increase from 3 or 4 attribute at a time. Now, the next indicator is the questioning, and this is a very important ability, and it's a very important dimension of learning of EVS classroom. Children will, if they'll get more opportunity to ask question, to frame question, to reflect the work of the children, this ability will be much, much more in a advanced level. And the questioning may be assessed by the using like expressing their curiosity. Some children are, you know, very curious. They not very much interested. Whatever is going on, they are just observing. You must have seen in your classroom that some children are very curious. They wanted to know why this thing is going on. Can we do this activity in that manner also? You must be seeing that in experimentation, some children are very, very creative and curious, and they would like to do this activity in a different manner also. So asking question and the framing simple questions, these if we will give opportunity to children to do such kind of activities, such kind of work in the classroom, this questioning ability will be developed, and the indicator of that EVS learning will be fulfilled. Now, analysis. Analysis again a very necessary for the learning of EVS in classroom, because the children are not only developing the knowledge but the understanding related to the various observable feature of the material. So analysis can be defining the situation or event. It's identifying the unpredicting ability, possible causes and effect may be judged by the analysis, and this is again an important indicator. Experimentation. Experimentation is which give scope to the learner in the hands-on activities, which give scope to the learner in a manipulative kind of activities in the classroom. So the more and more, two or more senses will be involved, and the activities will be going in a more qualitative manner. Concern and justice and equality. Like concern related to developing sensitivity for the disadvantaged group of the society, maybe the special need of the society, because the one of the important consideration of EVS learning is developing sensitivity for the environment, develop sensitivity for the disadvantaged group of the society, and the maybe the special need of the children. And last indicator, we can say the cooperation and support. cooperation in terms of taking initiative for improving the environment, taking initiative for sharing and working together, and the empathy for the love and affection and such component. Now we can say here one example I am taking here for the learning indicator discussion. You know, the discussion ability is as a parameter of learning EVS. In a class 3, if you can say, the discussion is a process and this is going on in a class 3, 4, 5. So the nature of the discussion in a class 3 is involving children in a group discussion, in a more simple kind of discussion, which is language wise and the concept wise is a simple. While in a class 4, engaging in a and participating children in a group discussion, which group discussion include a theme which is maybe little difficult from the class 3. While in a class 5, we can say participatory kind of activity and in a group discussion. So the discussion involves the complexity from class 3 to class 5. Similarly, listening other experiences and ideas. While in a class 4, listening other experiences and reflecting on, not only listening but reflecting on also. While in a class 5, listening carefully other experiences and not only reflecting but giving suggestion also to the group. Sharing experiences verbally and accept feedback of the peer group. While in class 4, you can say sharing own experiences and reflecting on own work. Similarly, in a class 5, sharing experiences and accept the learning gaps. Whatever gaps are there, they are not just reflecting or they are not just, but they are accepting what are the gaps and how to improve those gaps. So the we can say the EVS learning is process based. So what should be the parameter of mapping the progress? So, mapping the progress, if we can say assigning the level in each subject area indicate the range within which the children or the child learning and performance lie on these four performance parameters or four performance levels. And these are, we can say, the indicators assessing children learning and the level wise. And the level one means, even with support, the child performance has not yet reached the expected level. We say that child level of learning is at the level 1. While the level 2 learning, we are saying the child needs support from elders to reach the expected level. Our cutoff is child must know this thing in a class 3. So, if the we are making efforts and children again need some support to reach that expected level, we say it's the level 2. While in a level 3, we are saying child's performance at per the expected level. What is the expected level of learning in a class 3? And if children are fulfilling that expected level, we are saying the learner are at the level 3. So, these things we judge through the performance based on the learning indicator. And level 4 is the child performance beyond the expected level. It means they are not only completing the class 3, but they have the ability to develop the ability which can be given opportunity to the child even beyond level of learning. That is maybe the class level 4, the children performance beyond the expected level. So, the sharing with the child on regular basis, if the teacher is reporting, should be on regular basis, not in a one time. It's not a one time effort, it should regularly be reported. And sharing with parents in a monthly and quarterly basis. So, what is the role of the teacher in this endeavor? So, some important tips for you as a practitioner, that understanding steps of teaching learning process, it believes in process of mutual learning. More emphasis on skill development rather than the coverage of content. Following participatory approach, it should be followed by the teacher. Focusing on do how rather than the do no means it's a knowing how things are going on is more important rather than just having the information. It means the primacy we are giving in a construction rather than the compilation of information. Identifying their knowledge and information as age appropriate level of children. Teachers must build capacity to use assessment as a process rather than as a outcome component of learning. Context specific training and critical pedagogy is crucial. More time devoting on teaching learning process rather than on record keeping exercise. It means opportunity time for learning is more important rather than engaging in the record keeping. Teacher must provide inputs to children for creating atmosphere for group learning. So in conclusion, we can say the learning indicators are the criteria of assessment, and these learning indicators are process based in nature rather than the outcome based, and these indicators are based on some skills, some processes. And the most important processes for EVS learning are observation, explanation, classification, discussion. And these processes should be the integral part of the teaching learning process so that the EVS teacher can fulfill the expectations of EVS learning. Thank you.